What's up, party people? It's April the Sci-Fi Mombie, and I don't know if you caught it, because it seemed like they only put out the announcement on Instagram, but Seth MacFarlane and Liz Gillies was on Sirius XM last night, channel 69, which is the Broadway channel. I'm just going to call it that. I'll look that up later to make sure I get it right, and it was a really good interview. They were talking about the new holiday album, and they were talking about how they met each other.
I know that you guys worked together before, but how did you connect? Was it just in Hollywood? You like, who was a good vibrato, and then you both found each other?
Kind of.
More or less.
Yeah, we met at karaoke.
Wait, hold on. To make your two clowns meet, hit it.
Karaoke.
Holy living fuck.
We met
we met at a karaoke bar called the Brass Monkey in Hollywood.
What were you? My love, there's only you in my life. Was that the song you guys sang together?
Yeah, this is, was it? Yes.
No, but
yes.
You sang a song.
I'm going to say yes, because if I don't, he's going to keep going.
No, you sang a song. You sang, can it be I like myself, that one.
Oh, I did?
He likes
was
me,
that
she likes
the
me.
Brass Monkey?
How they're friends. How well they work together, how well their voices are. Would Seth ever do Broadway?
So, yeah. Elizabeth, you've done Broadway, but Barbara Streisand style, you did a show and never came back again. I find it rude. MacFarlane, you've got this great voice, and what? You're making too much money in Hollywood? You can't do a six-month run of Music Man on Broadway?
That pretty much sums it up.
Can we maybe bank some of our money and do a low-paying job on Broadway?
You did say bank, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
I know you spend most of it on booze and drugs, but I'm talking about just like for 6 months.
Just booze, really. Just booze. I'm terrified. I took an edible last Halloween and almost freaked out.
Edible?
Edible. Edible.
Oh, an edible. Oh, edible. Okay, no, I don't do any of that. I
edible,
take Adderall.
Like oh, okay.
Because I have ADD. I know you can't tell.
Do you take Adderall?
Isn't it weird
that
to me with ADD?
That is shocking.
Can we focus on your career? Why are you not doing Broadway, dear?
I there was an offer a number of years ago to go do Spamalot.
Which is back now.
I like Spamalot.
It's a little on the nose for you, though.
It's a little on the nose. If it was like, okay, hey, come do Billy Bigelow, I'd be like, oh, now you've got my attention.
My boy, Bill.
Yeah, yeah. Well, no, that's, you're right. Yeah.
Right? Am I wrong?
Oh, that's a beautiful song.
He does that one really
but
well.
But what's the most underratedly, not necessarily the most PC, the most underratedly beautiful melody in that show?
There was a lot of interesting things that I already knew. I think a lot of us already know. But, like, Seth was, like, rattling off composers. Here, listen to this.
Seth MacFarlane, your placement's amazing. I was literally just listening to it. So, first of all, you go, the tool's amazing. And then everyone thinks you're baritone, but then you enter in an A flat. Listen to this placement. I'm playing this for everybody. Listen to the tool placement, and then the A flat at the end is amazing. Okay, hold on. Good placement. And then no tension on the A flat. The bass is so relaxed. Get ready?
That's so high.
That's me desperately wanting to be Gordon McRae.
But Bobby, Gordon McRae wasn't really such a high singer, though.
Oh, he was. You listen to his stuff, he had a range, that guy. He had a serious... That was like an underratedly extraordinary... And amazingly, he could drink himself silly the night before and still sound like that. He would end these songs, you know, that would be singing way down here, and then the end note would be like... Ooh, be like way, way, even way higher than that.
But wait, if we're going to have a face-off, aren't you more of a John Raitt fan like I am more than Gordon?
I'm... Not really. I am hardcore the McRae.
You love Carousel?
Yeah, I love Carousel.
So I am a Gordon McRae fan-esque, but John Raitt, I have to say, I think tops him. And
wow.
I don't mean sexually.
I emphatically disagree. I think John Raitt is fantastic, but I think Gordon McRae has a texture, there's a subtlety, there's so many different hues to
and
his
colors. Okay, you know what?
Yeah. All the best orchestrations are in the films.
Yes.
They really are.
Because they're big orchestras.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah. And you got the great arrangers.
But I don't like watching them.
If you had to pick one, what would you pick?
Of a movie musical?
Yeah.
Sing in the Rain, because it's hilarious.
Sure.
It's the comedy of it. Why? What would yours be?
I'm not. No. Unfortunately, because of when I grew up, it's going to be something you hate. No, it's going to be way worse than
High School Musical 2?
No. It's probably going to
be... Oliver and Company.
Oh, shit. No. You know what?
American Mouse Tale?
Listen, I'll say this, and I'm going to get in a lot of trouble for saying this, but from you, I bet.
Yeah.
When I saw Hairspray in theaters,
that's okay.
I've never been in an audience like that in my entire life. It was the most intense thing I've ever been a part of.
That's an amazing score. I support.
It was fun. Choices were made. But I also I loved Michelle Pfeiffer's. I loved her in that. Don't you love when people Gillies? Sing and no, when she's like, just like you're on in a movie and it's on the sound. She's like, oh my God, how times have changed. Like the effort level. I'm just like, I'm so into that. I can't even.
And scores, boy, does he talk. He's that kind of person that, and he's even said so, that when he was a teenager, he didn't like mainstream music. So he would listen to records. He would listen to Broadway. He would listen to jazz and old time, you know, nostalgia that he just enjoyed. And Seth, not only did he keep calling them clowns, the host of the show, but he played like clips of Liz singing when she was 15 and when she was on Broadway and just so many good things. Like Seth did a whole series on BBC with jazz tunes and show tunes, and they're on YouTube. Go check them out. It's worth watching. They're worth watching. I think they're from 2011. Maybe they're before that. I gotta do more research. Story of my life. Because the fun never stops at the Sci-Fi Mombie house. That's for sure. But, you know, Liz has been on Family Guy. She's been on the Orville. I would love to see her return for season 4 of the Orville. Another God episode. Gods, whatever we want to call them, right? But it's like how they met at a karaoke bar and how Seth likes to put all of his friends to work, which is fabulous. You know, I would do that as well if I had that opportunity, like I put my kids to work. They're my producers. And I do all the content. I do all the work. So. But anyways, here is the interview. Some of it. I kind of, you know, popped in and out of it. Kind of like the Adriana Palicki, Michael Rosenbaum interview. Just to, you know, protect myself. But it's a good interview and it's a great album. And if you haven't listened to the album yet, it's on all the streaming platforms. It's also on vinyl. Vinyl. There's so much stuff coming back that's on vinyl right now. It's amazing. So Victor has a record player and he loves vinyl. And so we like try to buy him as much as possible for his birthday and Christmas and stuff like that. And I think he's still buying it. I don't know, I have to talk to him about it. But if you haven't listened to a record on vinyl or an 8-track tape or a cassette tape, that's how old I am, then you're missing out. The nostalgia, you know, CDs, it's like a black and white TV. My kids don't know what that is. And I had to explain it. And I had to explain to my kids that TV didn't go 24 hours a day before. You know the color bars that I had to use in media training when I was in college? That's where they came from. So, it's fascinating. But if you haven't heard this interview, and a lot of people didn't because it was Sirius, and you have to have a subscription to listen to Sirius XM, and it's not available in some countries. Hi, I'm April the Sci-Fi Mombie, and I will hook you up. And probably get in trouble for it. But you know what? I don't care. I push the bar. So, enjoy, and as always, party on, party people.
A show that's larger than life. just like its host. Here's Seth Rudetsky with more Seth Speaks on Broadway.
Hey everyone, it's Seth Rudetsky here on Seth Speaks. They're two of the greatest singers that ever have been, Seth MacFarlane and Liz Gillies from 13. That's the only credit I will ever acknowledge. I don't acknowledge TV credits, only Broadway credits.
I love
Seth, you need to come to Broadway.
This makes me want to take an Alka-Seltzer.
You are like the opposite.
Not because I'm sick to my stomach, but because of that jingle.
Okay, first of all, I've already cleared this with Seth MacFarlane. It is rude to have my name. I was the only, basically, Seth growing up on Long Island. I don't know why you're still called Seth. And as you said before, you're not even Jewish. Your middle name is literally like Addison. It's so...
Woodbury.
So Goyish. And by the way, your middle name is so Goyish. What is it, like Dylan?
No, it's wild. It's Egan. It's Scottish. Egan.
Ever hear of like Mordechai?
Elizabeth Egan Gillies.
We are like, and I used it on Broadway because you got to have three names on Broadway, of course. And then you have to have the shortest possible name once you get to like Hollywood. So I was Elizabeth Egan Gillies, the most space I could take up.
It's so obnoxious. Listen, these two clowns, they're TV people, but they're so musically talented. Like my head's going to come off. They're also the kind, I'm just going to, before I play a song, basically, I was talking to Jeremy Jordan, and he was talking about a vocal warm-up, and I said, oh my God, if I do that, I'll sound good. And he said, Seth, you can't change your natural tone. My point is, you guys were born with just perfect placement. It's like, Seth, this is your voice, and you have like the smoothest, like, so it's just natural, your voices. So it's infuriating. So they came out with this holiday album. I'll play Sleigh Ride.
God, I feel like I'm watching a FedEx commercial.
Why? What does that mean?
Because I speak so fast, but that's just my signature. This is one of their songs from their holiday album. It's called Happy Hanukkah, your album? I can't remember.
Happy Hanukkah. Oh, we wish you the merriest.
8 days of Jewishness. So anyway, this is Sleigh Ride. Listen how great they sound together, and then we're going to come back and talk more about it. Hit it.
Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Outside the snow is falling and friends are calling you. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, let's go. Let's look at the show. We're riding in a wonderland of snow.
Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, it's grand, just holding your hand.
We're gliding along with a song of a wintry fairyland.
Our cheeks are nice and rosy and comfy cozy are we. We're snuggled up together like two birds of a feather would be.
Let's take that road before us and sing us a chorus or two.
Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
There's a birthday party at the home of Farmer Gray.
It'll be the perfect ending of a perfect day.
We'll be singing the songs we love to sing without a single stop.
At the fireplace where we watch the chestnuts
pop,
pop, pop, pop.
There's a happy feeling nothing in the world can buy.
When they pass around the coffee and the pumpkin pie,
it'll nearly be like a picture print by Courier and Ives.
These wonderful things.
These wonderful things.
These wonderful things.
These wonderful things are the things we'll never want through our lives.
Just hear those sleigh bells jingling, ring, ting, tingling too.
Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Let's take that road before us and sing us a chorus or two.
A chorus or two.
Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
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 This is Seth Speaks on Broadway. Now back to the show with your host, the amazing Seth Rudetsky.
Okay, so I know that you guys worked together before, but how did you connect? Was it just in Hollywood? You're like, who has a good vibrato? And then you both found each other?
Kind of.
More or less.
Yeah, we met at karaoke.
Wait, hold on. Do we get Ixie from live? Who's the downer that said we can't live stream?
It's your team.
Have you heard of promoting?
Mine?
I'm kidding. I don't have a team.
Okay. Who's the MacFarlane team that said we can't live stream
Okay.
This is going on the radio. I was live streaming, but I was forbidden because I'm already canceled and Seth is 1 inch away from
being
canceled.
How'd you get canceled?
How'd I get canceled? Basically, I think just being too old.
I understand.
I'm interested in my career anymore.
I get it.
Not canceled for racism, just like untalentedness. Anyway, wait. Okay, so wait, go. How did you two clowns meet? Hit it.
Karaoke.
Holy living fuck.
We
met at a karaoke bar called the Brass Monkey in Hollywood.
Well, my love, there's only you in my life. Was that the song you guys sang
together?
Yeah,
this is, was it?
You sang a song.
I'm going to say
Seth.
Yes, because if I don't, he's going to keep going.
No, you sang a song. You sang, Can It Be I Like Myself, that one.
Oh, I did?
He likes
was
me,
that
she likes
me. Was the Brass Monkey?
You eventually
you know
were.
And you call yourself a Broadway person.
I am a Broadway person. Wait, that's from a Broadway show?
Can it be? I like myself. She likes me, so I like myself.
It's
from
not
a movie.
Stephen
it's
musical.
From a movie.
Okay, that's not Broadway.
Well, but so, it's kind of, you know.
Okay, that's like, no.
Starring Gene Kelly and Dan Daly and Sid Charisse.
I love Gene Kelly, but it's not probably Seth. That's like saying movies are TV. They're not the same thing.
It's classic MGM. It's like the golden era. It's like some of the greatest music this country's ever produced.
Well, you know what? He sings all the time. That's definitely Broadway. He sings Old Man River, Sinatra's version, but he sings it all the time.
Wait, you also sing. By the way, you're the king of Broadway because you're always singing, well, we got this.
Yeah.
Right.
You do it so well.
That's a Meredith Wilson tune, right?
That's amazing. Oh, you know what? I'm going to play. I'm playing right now.
It's so good.
Seth MacFarlane, your placement's amazing. I was literally just listening to it. So first of all, you go the tool's amazing, and then everyone thinks you're baritone, but then you enter in an A flat. Listen to this placement. I'm playing this for everybody. Listen to the tool placement, and then the A flat at the end is amazing. Okay, hold on. Hold on. Tool. Great placement. And then no tension on the A flat. The bass is so relaxed. Get ready.
That's so high.
That's me desperately wanting to be Gordon McRae.
But Bobby, Gordon McRae wasn't really a high singer, though.
Oh, he was. You listen to his stuff, he had a range, that guy. He had a serious, that was like an underratedly extraordinary, and amazingly, he could drink himself silly the night before and still sound like that. He would end these songs, you know, that would be singing way down here, and then the end note would be like, ooh, be like way higher than that.
But wait, if we're going to have a face-off, aren't you more of a John Raitt fan like I am more than Gordon?
I'm not really. I am hardcore the McRae.
You love Carousel?
Yeah, I love Carousel.
Do you know who Gordon McRae's daughter is?
Sheila McRae, right?
Yes, but Heather McRae is the Broadway star.
Oh,
She did play Sheila in Hair. So if you watch the Tony Awards from 69.
I want to play Sheila in Hair.
It's great. She sings, we starve, look at one another. Yes, so that's his daughter. Broadway star, also star of Falsetto Land. So I am a Gordon McRae fan-esque, but John Raitt, I have to say, I think tops him. And
wow.
I don't mean sexually.
I emphatically disagree. I think John Raitt is fantastic, but I think there's a Gordon McRae has a there's a texture, there's a subtlety. There are so many different hues to
and
his
colors. Okay, you know what? Yeah. I admit I really don't know movie musicals at all. I really just know Broadway.
Oh, that's a shame.
You know what? I have to tell you why. I hate lip syncing. And that's really why. So every time I watch a movie, I go, ugh, they're not really singing.
But all the best orchestrations are in the films.
Yes.
They really are.
Because they're bigger orchestras.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah. And you got the great arrangers.
But I don't like watching them.
If you had to pick one, what would you pick?
Of a movie musical?
Yeah.
Sing in the Rain, because it's hilarious.
Sure.
It's the comedy of it. Why? What would yours be?
I'm not. No. Unfortunately, because of when I grew up, it's going to be something you hate. No, it's going to be way worse than
High School Musical 2?
No. It's probably going to
Oliver and Company.
Oh, shit. No. You know what?
American Mouse Tale?
Listen, I'll say this, and I'm going to get in a lot of trouble for saying this, but from you, I bet.
Yeah.
When I saw Hairspray in theaters,
that's okay.
I've never been in an audience like that in my entire life. It was the most intense thing I've ever been a part of.
That's an amazing score. I support.
It was fun. Choices were made. But I loved Michelle Pfeiffer's. I loved her in the, don't you love when people
Gillies?
Sing and, when she's like, just like you're on in a movie and it's on the sound. She's like, oh my god, how times have changed. Like the effort level. I'm just like, I'm so into that. I can't even tell you how into that I am.
That's an amazing imitation.
Oh my god, I love it. I do it all the time. But yeah, that's a good one. That's a good one for me.
Wait, MacFarlane, did you see her when she was on Broadway?
Are you chewing gum?
I would have been 15.
No, Liz and I were drunk when we met.
I wasn't drunk. I'm never drunk.
You weren't?
No.
I don't think either.
We were drunk in a karaoke bar. And because we started to talk about this earlier. And okay, I'm going to say, like, most of the time when you sing a classic song nowadays, you sing it like this. Chestnuts roasting on an open fire.
Oh, yeah.
And it doesn't need your help, you know. You know, I've got you under my skin. You know, you don't. Cole Porter doesn't need you helping him out. And then here goes Liz singing like Julie London or Nancy Wilson or one of these great vocalists singing "Cry Me a River." And I was like, that's very rare, even for somebody who's like 70 these days.
Yes, there were no melisma, so you were impressed by the literalness of her voice.
And
yes.
We were the only two singing that type of music there. Yeah. The place, a lot of people frequented that place, a lot of Hollywood people, and it's usually like, you know, Journey and what you'd think, and Seth and I were sort of just singing exclusively standards, so we decided, we had a conversation after we met, and we decided maybe we should see if we sound good together and we could do this on the road a little
bit. A, you sound amazing. B, your first album, you do one of my favorite songs by Steve Allen, You're Walking Along.
Yeah. That's my favorite off that album.
Is it? By the way, I'm obsessed. Why is the backup fig
like, I know it's so weird. Fig
like, yeah, it's, they were experimental. Stephen Eady.
They really
He was also, wasn't he kind of a Steve Allen, he wrote like great songwriter, but he kind of a cranky guy, wasn't he
well, wasn't
like,
he the host, the original host of
The Tonight Show. Yeah.
No, I didn't know that. That's amazing.
So Steve Allen wrote it, but it was Steve Lawrence and Edie Gourmet that sang it. By the way, Steve Lawrence is hilarious. I got to do the Carbonette 50th special with Steve Lawrence.
Oh.
And at one point I walked up to him, I was showing him his harmony part. And I said, right here, you have a little part. And he said, who told you? It was a penis joke. Anyway,
it's really funny.
Yeah, right.
It is odd though. Like a guy who hosted The Tonight Show. He was a talk show host and yet could write, and I think he wrote words and music.
Yeah, but by the way, you were an animation major at RISD, but you do voices, but you have amazing. I'm just saying, you're multi-talented too, dear.
If I had written one of Steve Allen's songs, I'd be happy.
You retire?
Yeah, well, I wouldn't retire, but I'd feel pretty good about myself.
But do you write music, by the way? You're so musical.
My musical notation ability is not exceptional.
But you know, a lot of those clowns, even unfortunately on Broadway, will hum a song and then someone will write the chords to it. You don't want to do like half writing.
I mean, it's kind of cheating, isn't it? Yeah. It's like
100%.
Yeah,
I mean, yes.
You have people who are
depends on the song. I think if you really, I do think it depends. If you're writing one of these songs, like you're writing a big piece, then yes, I would say probably.
There are instances, yeah, where like there's a really good song, a really good melody, and then the arranger takes it and makes it great. I think there's a lot of examples of that.
Well, also, by the way, new pop songs today, because they're all a lot of them written by no talent, so it's just like the skies. You know when you learn piano when you're 8 years old?
And that's even better. That chord would never happen. The one you just played. No, really. That's like some...
Written by no talents. Like who?
I don't...
Dish.
I don't even mean MacFarlane. Hold on, wait. I was talking about this could be the start of something big. Can we just play it? So this is their amazing first album before they went all Hanukkah. Yep. Hit it.
This could be the start of something wonderful. Why don't you take a chance? Just try romance with me. And see.
You're watching the sun come up and counting your money,
girl.
Or else in a dim cafe, you're ordering
wine.
Then suddenly there she is, and you want to be where she is. And this must be the start of something. This could be the heart of something. This could be the start of something.
Listen to that placement. Okay, by the way, what's the name of the first album? Like Songs from Home?
Songs from Home. Because we were, you know, we were apart. It was the pandemic and we wanted to make music.
We're apart.
Like, because we're always together.
We're not married to each other.
We're not married.
No.
You're the comedy green. Okay, hold on. I'm playing more placement.
We're both married to Christ.
to Christ and jazz.
I'm playing, first of all, the amazing placement of a certain person that's sitting right here.
Hi. That's Okay, okay.
What is
that? That's me when I was 15.
13.
But here's the thing about that.
She's amazing.
You know, well, I always laugh. When you first did your thing.
When I deconstructed you?
When you deconstructed us, Ari and I were like, it's out. We got to look at it. We got to read it. It's out. Not read it. Listen to it. And you were, your thing that made me laugh so much was the a-put. When I did a-put that. I always add, and I do it on this album. We were singing.
A-put that away.
We were singing live yesterday, and I was like, holy shit, I just did the thing I've been doing since I was like literally 14 years old. I say, a-look how the snow is snowing. I said, what the fuck did I say? A-look. I add an a. I know, and I was like, maybe you're
influenced. That's classic, isn't it?
Not a-look. It's like, just
a-look how the snow.
She's literally, when she's 13 years old, she's describing to her nerdy friend what to do if a guy unzips his fly.
She's hot. She's just prude, and I'm a whore.
She's hot, and she's basically saying, like, when you see it, you go, put that away. And I was obsessed with the hyphen put.
Yeah.
You still got it.
You were giving me notes today, so that probably hasn't
really
changed. When we were over at the other show. Whatever that was that we just did.
We've done about 15 shows, but this is the most fun.
Thank you. By the way, if you don't know, they've been up since 4 a.m. They did, I want to say the Today Show?
Yeah. They did the Today Show. Yeah, we sang a couple songs there, and then we've been bopping around here a little bit.
I got to play something from your actual album. So hold on. It's a holiday album. I wrote down songs it up. It's a holiday album. You guys did Winter Wonderland. Seth, you're a little basso profundo-y on this, I have to say. You really show your range. No, but you really show your low notes, the B. Arthur-ness of it all.
The B. Arthur-ness of it all.
It's because we have a really similar range, so what happens is Seth has
Vic
to go
Tabak-ness
really low.
The of it all. Yeah, it is.
First of all, Vic Tabak's an amazing reference. Lily Mel? Okay, wait, before I play it, and speaking of B. Arthur, can we discuss the brilliance of the extended Maud theme song? Who thought of it? Who wrote it?
Oh, yeah. That was a collaborative effort in the Family Guy writer's room. That there was a Family Guy gag where we took the theme song from Maud and like came up with like every great female achiever that we could think of in history and just kind of made the song a mile long.
Oh, fun.
It's, hold on, well, since, you know, of course I have it because I'm obsessed with it. So why don't we just listen to the brilliance of it all? It's so effing funny. So it's basically, it's the, what do they call it, the extended version of it?
Sure.
Okay, hold on. And of course,
the dance cut.
Hold on, it's not playing. I'm playing it after we play the song. So everyone, first I'm going to play Winter Wonderland. How do we get this album, by the way? We just go to Sam Goody? Where is it?
Sam Goody or...
Sam Goody. Yeah, you go to...
Virgin Records.
You can go to Strawberry's Records and Tapes.
You can go to Tower still around?
I don't know if any HMV. Still around.
This album is...
Coconuts.
I mean, you can also buy it on vinyl, which is fun. Our album is...
I saw that it was like side two. I'm like, side two?
Yeah. And one is totally green, which is cool too. Yeah, but it sounds beautiful on vinyl.
Yeah, vinyl. Oddly, not a record vinyl. It just comes stitched into a couch.
Well, it's like vinyl pants, like Daphne Rubin Vega from Rent.
I have them in pants.
Okay, hold on. Here's the extended mod.
Is this you?
No.
No bridge.
Clara Barton was a famous nurse who was rapping with the soldiers and banter just to Susan B. Anthony, always outdoing stuff, marching
so
around on that upside.
And then there's more.
Pocahontas had all going on. An Indian guide with lots of Indian pride. Indira Gandhi ran a whole big country.
Truly hard.
That isn't easy, even if you're a guy.
And then there's more.
Frustrating.
And then there's more.
Amelia Earhart flew a lot of airplanes, except for that one time when she didn't come back. Cleopatra lived.
And then there's more. Come on.
But still found a way to keep herself looking fine. And then there's more.
That is so effing funny.
It's probably a low percenter for our audience, even at the time.
Well, it's definitely you have to be basically over 45 to get it. Yeah. Elizabeth's like, what's Maud?
No, I know it.
She knows what Maud is.
I know it. What you were seeing is sort of like an odd fade of like how long I've been awake, but enjoying it, really enjoying it.
Laughing inside, that kind of audience drives me crazy.
No.
Okay, can we go back to singing? So, Elizabeth, you've done Broadway, but Barbara Streisand style, you did a show and never came back again. I find it rude. MacFarlane, you've got this great voice, and what? You're making too much money in Hollywood? You can't do a 6-month run of music? Man on Broadway.
That
pretty much sums
it
up.
Can we maybe bank some of our money and do a low-paying job on Broadway?
You did say bank, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
I know you spend most of it on booze and drugs, but I'm talking about just like for 6 months.
Just booze, really, just booze. I'm terrified. I took an edible last Halloween and almost freaked out.
Edible?
Edible. Edible.
Oh, an edible. Oh, edible. I don't do any of that. Edible. I take Adderall.
Oh, okay.
Because I have ADD. I know you can't tell.
Do you take Adderall?
Isn't it weird
that
to think of me with ADD?
That is shocking.
Can we focus on your career? Why are you not doing Broadway, dear?
There was an offer a number of years ago to go do Spamalot.
Which is back now.
I just saw it.
And
I like Spamalot.
It's a little on the nose for you, though.
It's a little on the nose. If it was like, okay, hey, come do Billy Bigelow, I'd be like, oh, now you've got my attention.
My boy, Bill.
Yeah, yeah. Well, no, that's, yeah, you're right. Yeah.
Right? Am I wrong?
Oh, that's a beautiful song.
He does that one really
but
well.
But what's the most underratedly, not necessarily the most PC, the most underratedly beautiful melody in that show? You got it. You got it. You got it. Look at this. He knows his shit.
Of course he does.
But here's the thing. It is PC because it is showing why people stay in abusive relationships. It's not saying this is good.
Right.
She's saying, look, I'm married and that's my theory.
What song?
What's the use of wondering if he's good?
I hope you're right, because there's a thing at the end where she says, where the daughter says,
a slap can feel like a kiss.
Yeah. Is it exactly?
It's not great.
Is it true, mother, that a guy can slap you real loud and hard and have it not hurt at all? And as if that's not bad enough, the mom then says,
"Yes, darling,
it is true. A guy can slap you loud and hard and have it not hurt at all." They double down. I don't know that really is that saying that it's bad or is that.
I can't imagine that one holds up.
Yeah. I don't know that there's two ways to look at that.
Isn't it called like she's a mess and we're sort of seeing that she's a mess? I don't think the authors
are going.
You're
saying is it a story of delusion and a flawed character.
Yeah.
Right, exactly.
I just feel like it ends though. You know, where like the guy, where he walks off into the sunset. I guess he was a good guy after all, even though he was always hitting people.
It's all good. I know what you mean. I'll look into it if I ever revive it with you. But that's your point. You don't want to do just an on-the-nose comedy. You want to like show your chops and do something.
Yeah. Well, I mean, that's beautiful. That's a beautiful score. That is a very emotionally moving score. That's probably Richard Rodgers, in my opinion, probably his best score.
Yeah, it has the most storing ballads.
Yeah,
but what about, do you know the show, which I think you'd be so right for, Shenandoah?
I don't know Shenandoah.
John Cullum. I've heard it all 1,000 times. It's a great show. All these very baritone-y. It's about the Civil War. It's an amazing show. I'm sending you a link through 7 of your people because I'll never get your actual email, and they're going to delete it. But I will still send you that link. You're not allowed to send links to his people.
I will absolutely watch that clip.
It was John Cullum, but it's never been revived since. I'm just saying. Mm. Now, Gillis, what about you? Why did you desert me after you did 13?
Shane Gillis, why did you desert him?
Yeah.
I would love to do Broadway again.
Yes.
No, I really, really want to. I want to do it.
TV star.
No, it's not that. I honestly, if I'm being honest with you, I think I'd love to originate a role
or be in a
revival of something that I've always wanted to be a part of. So I'm just waiting for that. That's all it is. I'm dying to do it.
But you can't be in LA.
I also got taken. I got taken and put in Atlanta doing Dynasty for 5 years, and that really took the light out of my eyes. So I'm
taken.
I'm just coming back.
It was a hostage situation.
They're going to take you.
No, now that I'm free,
they're going to put you on Dynasty.
But wait, why can't you guys? You are a writer. Why don't you write an
episode? At some point, we've been in talks. But you know what? Liz brings up a good point. Broadway is a commitment. You gotta love. That's the thing. You gotta love the music. Like Carousel's a show. Sure, I could do that night in, night. I'd never get tired of those songs. Not ever.
Right. There are several shows like that.
Mamma Mia. Hello.
Listen, I enjoy ABBA very much. Could I hear it night after night? I don't know.
I did until I was fired.
Did you really?
Yeah. Samara.
Were you in?
I was in the orchestra, and I posted. I said, "Mamma Mia has a 9-person band and lip syncing.
Wow!
And it's in the same theater where West Side Story was. Where's the outrage?"
Fired. So essentially, you said no, thank you for the music.
I said, no, thank you for the music. Thank you. And I got fired.
That's actually a good song. ABBA's like, it's like that Barry Manilow thing where it's like they take a lot of shit, but there's some really good songs.
100%. And Barry, you know? I agree with you. Barry Manilow is an amazing writer.
Great songwriter.
You know, ABBA wrote Chess. Do you know the score to Chess? That's.
I've never heard Chess.
It's.
Oh, my God.
People love Chess.
By the way, he just put his hands to his face like Home Alone.
No, because you know what? Because you'd be an amazing Florence and he'd be an amazing Anatole.
Perhaps we revive Chess.
Well, Why can't we do a one-night concert of it? You'd sound great.
See, that's the dream. By the way, one-night concert now, like, our ears are perked up. That
that's all
awesome.
I do one-night. That's why I did
It's an unfortunate title, though, isn't it? One, like, if you're not into, like...
Or one-night concert.
Well, it doesn't exactly... Like, the sound of music, flower drum song, you know, South Pacific, these grandiose, larger-than-life titles, and then chess.
It's devastating. But there's another show called Rags. Anybody? Yeah. That's a great show. Yeah. Wait a minute.
Let's revive backgammon.
Yeah.
Wait a minute.
Sorry.
You don't know that man, no madness, though their sad powers may prevail. It's beautiful music. Okay, I'm doing a one-night concert, and we could do it in L.A. So you're doing Florence, and you're doing Anatoly, but who's going to be Freddie? We'll have Anna Paschal do it.
Done.
I did it with Adam and Josh Groban. You did the Josh Groban part.
Yeah, you could do Josh Groban.
What's the charity that we're doing it for? Are we doing it for Actors Fund like I did my last one?
Well, he's got a real, Josh Groban, he's got a real operatic, I mean, he's got a,
you
that's
could
a
do
story
it,
your
yeah.
voice is really
you
right
could
for
do
it.
It.
Your voice is so right for it, I'm telling you, I'm being in touch.
I'm also, you know what, I'm kind of, you wouldn't like, I mean, I fake it on the album a bit, but I'm really an alto, that's another Broadway issue I have.
Right here, nope,
No. Proof. I promise I am, I'm really, I can sing really low, Seth, I can do it right
I
now.
I am not fit to carry Josh Groban's water.
Hold on, be quiet everybody, focus for a second. This is the C sharp. With full vibrato.
Depends on the vowel. Depends on the vowel.
Right, exactly.
But Broadway.
Here we go. I said to the sun, good morning, sun. That's a C sharp.
That is very impressive.
I could do for...
He's not wrong.
But he knows. We recorded this together. I can do... It depends where it lands. Like, Holiday Feeling, for example, ends with, we've got that holiday feeling now! And
God.
I was literally like, oh, I was like,
ah! That sounds like that Dance Monkey song.
Do you want me to... Damn, my. He loves this. I can't say it.
I love it when Liz...
I also have notes. I've had notes forever, and that's a big... really freaks Broadway out.
When she does the angry singing.
You know, the other like when I do the angry singing, it gets like it's all
somebody
great.
Gets targeted.
Hey, that's an amazing... way. First of all, let's play Holiday Feeling so we could hear Liz...
Have
her
a baby.
Face
well, no, it's not. It's a bit of a skrelt, to be honest.
I don't care. I love
what?
It. Hit it. Skrelt. It's
scream
belting,
belt.
But it's beyond belting.
Oh, it's like belt. It has a little more. Yeah.
It's called the skrelt. Hit it.
So, Seth, you got anything special on your list this year?
Nothing I could say out loud.
Oh, really? Well, maybe you can whisper it softly into my ear.
Well, that's one of the things on my list.
Look how the snow is snowing.
Your eyes are soft and glowing.
Jack Frost is nipping at our feet.
I'll bet your lips are warm and sweet.
We've got that holiday feeling. That happy holiday feeling.
Let's roast chestnuts by the fire.
Any little thing you desire.
Those reindeer soon will be here.
Won't mean a thing to me, dear.
When Santa Claus begins his flight,
I hope he gets a flat tonight.
We've got that holiday feeling. That happy holiday feeling. Our favorite holiday all the year.
You'd better leave.
It's been so lovely here like this. A chance I'd never miss.
But it's so late.
On New Year's Eve, the 12 o'clock we'll stop to kiss. And while the whole world will be whistle-blowing,
mistletoeing.
Hey, Liz, are there really 12 days of Christmas?
I think so.
Well, then, we better pace ourselves.
You think you're such a smarty.
Come on, let's have a party.
I know what's running through your mind.
This is the season to be kind.
We've got that holiday feeling. That happy holiday feeling.
So come and snuggle close to me.
Right here where you're supposed to be.
Let's kiss, cause it's the season, dear. Let's kiss, who needs a reason, dear? We've got that holiday feeling.
So, did you get everything on your list?
Almost. What do you say to some reindeer games?
Your chimney or mine?
I'll bring the chestnuts.
We're still talking about Christmas, right?
Here's...